Hi dear students, in today's class we are going to discuss about some important grammar topics which includes articles and reflexive pronouns. Let's go with articles first. What are the articles? Yes, of course you know, you have already learned that a, an and the are the articles. And here we can classify them into two as definite articles and indefinite articles. A and an are called the indefinite articles, while the is called as the definite article. The indefinite articles a and an are used with the singular subjects only. When we are using it with an uncountable noun or plural nouns, we will be using some instead of a or an. At the same time, the definite article the is used with both singular nouns and plural nouns, and we'll be using it with uncountable nouns like water, spirits, tree, such words also. Let's go with the first paragraph exercise with now. I'm going to read the complete paragraph right now with the filled blanks. Once upon a time, you have to write a there. There were large forests in India. There is no article used there. You have to put an into mark there. Where numerous kinds of trees grew. As the population increased, the people began cutting down trees and using them as fuel. So here, the is used just in the beginning, and then we are not using any article in the next. We thus lost a lot of, you have to write a there, our forest wealth. Now we are trying to replace this loss, and our government is planting trees all over the country. Now you have to use the in the last part. We celebrate an unusual festival. You have to write and there. In honor of trees, there is no article used there. You have to put an into mark there. It's called Vana Mahotsava or the forest festival. Here you have to use the article the. On this day we plant a number of new trees. The neem tree in front of our classroom was planted by the school gardener on the first Vana Mahotsava festival. The tree is now tall and shady. What was the Trojan horse? A story of the Trojan War was told in the poem called The Iliad by the great poet Homer. The Greeks and the Trojans were at a war for some years. In 1200 BC, the Greeks stopped besieging the city of Troy and apparently disappeared, leaving behind them a huge wooden horse. At night, while the Trojans slept, the Greek soldiers who had been hiding inside the horse slipped out from inside it, killed the Trojan guards and led the waiting Greek soldiers inside the city. Soon the Troy was destroyed. Although the city of Troy did exist and a war did take place, the legend of the Trojan horse may be just that, a legend. Here I have shared the answer of your textbook exercise for the articles, and all are requested to do that in your text. Next important grammar topic which we are having as a part of this lesson is reflexive pronouns. Let's have a look at the definition. A reflexive pronoun shows that the action of the verb in the sentence affects the person who performs the action, which means it shows the strong bond of the verb in the sentence with the person who is performing the action. The words like myself, yourself, himself, herself, themselves, ourselves, itself, those words are known as reflexive pronouns. Let's see the exercise part right now. Have you noticed how Biju keeps looking at himself in the mirror? Himself is the answer that is already given there. And the second one, she had to force herself to eat. The answer is herself. The third one, can you repair this iron or must we do it ourselves? Did you cut your hair yourself. Here all, whatever is the subject, with that a self is added to make a reflexive pronoun. You, yourself. We, ourselves. Am I right? She, herself. The same way you can fill the other exercise also. Hope you got a clear-cut idea about reflexive pronouns. Here it's time for me to wind up. Thank you. Have a nice day.